Hello everybody, my name is Scott Cart. Welcome to my lab. Today we have a short video about repairing circuit boards. In this case, we've had an oversight with a voltage regulator and we simply need to tie the enable pins to power. Because we do not require much current, I'm going to use magnet wire to tie the two pins high. So without further ado, let's get started. Welcome back everybody. As you can see, the magnet wire is quite small. I believe it's about a 42 AWG. The great thing about wire gauge this small is that we do not need to strip the varnish off of it. The soldering iron will simply melt the varnish and the flux will clean it sufficiently to stick to the pins. Here, you can see the first regulator we want to make the jumpers on. We're going to jumper from pins 3 to pin 1 and pin 6. Note this is a very small part, approximately 2 by 3 millimeters. Here you can see I'm tinning the first lead of the IC. I've got the wire placed into the solder and I will allow it to heat the wire. Once it's sufficiently hot, the varnish will be vaporized and the joint made. It is important to make sure that we have the temperature set low enough on the soldering iron as not to lift any traces. It is very easy to damage traces if we turn up the heat. In this case, I have the soldering iron set to 330 degrees Celsius, which is my normal temperature for lead-free solder. Once the joint is finished, we'll test the joint by pulling on the wire before moving on to the next joint. Because of the limited space that we must make these connections in, you can see that I'm using a very fine set of tweezers to get in and manipulate the wire. You will also note that the soldering iron tip that I'm using is not the finest, but it is sharp. The reason for this is that we want to be precise and not heat other areas of the circuit board, but we do want good thermal conductivity through the soldering tip. One thing that we often see with students is that they tend to use higher temperatures to compensate for the lack of conductivity as they're trying to solder larger joints. I'll now test the second connection. We can see that it is good, and I'll move on to the third. The third joint is just a repeat of what we've done on the second joint. We want to make sure that we have a nice loop for our magnet wire so that we do not cause any shorts. Again, once the joint is complete, we want to check it before we use a knife to cut the tail off the wire. We do want to be careful not to damage any of the other traces or components in the area. This board has a second regulator with the same part and issue, so we'll repeat the process. As you can see, it's not a difficult modification to make, and hopefully understand that mistakes when designing are inevitable. I often tell my students that mistakes are very easy to make, especially with prototypes. It's so easy to miss a point in a data sheet or misunderstand a design specification. Now, this wasn't my design, but I've made several errors like this. We have resolved this issue with our modification in the first iteration, and this is the sort of thing that we expect to happen when we're prototyping, especially when we're in a rush and we don't have time to vet our design fully. This will only be done for a handful of boards to test the rest of the design, and the second version is already in the design stage, likely to be completed for manufacture in the next day or two. This is something that we have come to expect. Hopefully you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If not, I'd love to hear your comments down below. If you'd like to be made aware when I make more videos, do hit the notify bell and subscribe as it helps my channel. If you'd like to support me in the work that I do here on YouTube, please check out my web store, link down in the description. As always, thanks for your time. All right, bye now.